It's only 10 a.m. and package has already arrived. So lucky. If I was unable to get a FedEx delivery, the only way to get it is to go out into the middle of nowhere in some kind of creepy industrial field and call them from a tiny room. This is a nice box. I'm gonna have to reuse it. Oh my god! Okay. I opened this without ready to get it. Oh my god. Pretty excited about these. This is an order from CatPrint. I didn't realize that they shipped by FedEx. And I'm not a big fan of that, but holy cow. Ho ho. Ho ho ho. Oh my goodness. Oh, oh my god. So my plan was to cut these and then I would end up with nice little trading cards. Blank on the other side. I'll have to make a sticker for the back or something, but damn. Look at this. So sparkly. Oh my goodness. Oh, I love it so much. Oh man. Oh, I'm so happy that I'm mostly caught up so I can have time to deal with this stuff. Oh, because last week I was like, I have things to do. I can't stop and papers and things, but now I can't. Oh, I love it. Oh, I love it. I love it. I love it. And look how many there are. There's so many more than I thought there were going to be. Like, look at these. I should actually count this. Because sometimes they send extra, so I can't actually remember how many I ordered. I think I ordered, how many are there? One, two, three, four, five. 7 times 5, I think I ordered 5. Anyway, while I figure that out, here's the printed products here. Oh, these are so pretty. So thick. This is not a great view. Sorry. Dang. I needed enough for 28 books, or 25 books, so I got 13, but there's more than 13 here, so I've heard of things like this happening, actually. Maybe they do it just in case something messes up, so that they have, because I imagine they do print runs, and if they muck up a copy, it would be hard to set it up again, so maybe they just make extras in case. Thank you so much. I love them. I love holding this giant stack in my hands. I love mail. I love this box. I love everything. I love it so much. It's kind of nice and glossy. Quality is good. This is the cover. Oh man. Oh man. Oh, I'm having a good morning. I think he may have gone into hibernation mode. He just sits in there now. Aren't you pretty? So pretty. The heck? What are you doing? This is not right. Look at all these aphids. So I cut all the cards. And they're pretty cool. I was going to take these to the show if they let me. I don't know if I would sell them individually or in small packs. Because I think it would be pretty fun if I had like a pack of five or something and sold them as trading cards. And so if a bunch of people buy them at the exhibition opening, they could use it as an activity instead of standing around looking at art and being kind of awkward. It could also just be like trading cards with each other, which is a pretty decent icebreaker, I think. I don't know if they will let me do that. I'll have to email them and find out. I also don't really have anything in mind as to what I would wrap these in for packs, but that would be super fun. I think it would be super fun, even though I'm super introverted, and the last time I did trading card things, it was really awkward and embarrassing, but yeah. Maybe I can do a few card packs, and then sell a few individual ones as well for people who just really aren't into that. But numbers are limited, so I don't know if I have enough to do both. I have a little bit of time to think about it, so I don't know. What should I do? I really like this one. I know you're supposed to get really dark colors for the holographic ones, but I like how subtle the rainbow is on the really light colors. I don't know. I like them. I like it better combined with white than with black. So sparkle. So sparkle. That one's the best holographic one, I think. I'm happy I get to work on something today. Ha 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 ha. This is after folding everything and cutting it. There's still some trimming to do, and it's not bound yet. I'd really like to staple it, but I don't have a stapler, so I'm going to decide whether or not to get a stapler or just sew it. But anyway, I ordered enough for 25, and I got 27 and a half. Which is cool. Means I get two extra. Yes. Yep. Man, I really wouldn't mind being able to staple it though. Just because the covers, the cardstock is quite thick, so it would be nice to not have to sew that, but I don't know. I don't think even a regular stapler could do that. I decided just to sew it. So here we go. I tried trimming the edge on some of them, but it was not working for me. I just kept ripping bits of it, and it was not working, so I gave up on that. Yeah, so it has my artist statement in the front. It has some pictures, some photo references. Me. Place where I did it. Whole stack done. Ugh, I'm tired now. Oh my god. My God, I keep saying I'm just gonna finish this sketchbook today. I got so much time. I had 3 days off in a row. I should be able to finish this. Ugh, such a drag. I have this page and a page back here. Like, that's it. I should be able to finish this today. But I keep getting sidetracked by things like putting labels on my zines and cards. I kind of want to make sketchbooks. Ugh, and tomorrow's a nice day, so I kind of wanted to leave the house. It's only 3:30. If I was a motivated person, which I'm not, I could easily finish this. But I'm also wrestling with the fact that there's no real accomplishment to finishing this in one day, because what do I get from this? Nothing. No one cares. Except for maybe a flip video. Oh, that'd be nice to be able to do a flip video. Maybe get ahead in videos a little bit so that my vlogs aren't kind of stale already by the time they come out. Yeah. Yeah. I need to have more interesting dreams. I think that's what's happening, is that my dreams have been so boring lately that there's nothing to sketch from them. And I'm trying to sketch from them because I want to do more of this places series, but in dreamscapes rather than real places. That's why I was drawing all the real places, so that I could practice for fake places. But yeah. Bleh. Well, yeah. Oh, it's such a drag, and I'm so bored and alone. I need a, I'd really love a sweet drink of some kind. One of them caffeine drinks that I can't have. Ugh. Oh, yeah, and John's coming home late tonight, too. Okay, I cheated. I don't feel like drawing just junk for the sake of filling out my book, so I'm just gonna glue some pages together. And I'll finish this one, and then that's it. Done with this one. No more. No more big pages, please. I was filming a sketchbook flip through because I sort of gave up on it, and I noticed that this did not glue, and it's being held on by tape. I'm thinking of maybe just taking this cover off. It's a nice cover, but it's broken. It's so broken. So I think that this is just not gonna work for me. Sorry. Wow. It's really disappointing. I mean, it's not surprising. And I did not, like, buy this book, so I don't really care, but, like, I'll give it a nice little soft cover. How about that? Something I can just glue, except that what keeps the cover on? Tape again? Jeez. Books, man. Books. There. That should do for a few days. Oh well. I tried. It's a little bit... it's fine. It's dizzying. Ugh. Yeah, what? Huh? Today is Thursday, I think, and I have a bunch of things I printed out so I can make some art journal / sketchbook covers. I thought it might be cool to have some to bring with me to the show, I guess, if they let me do that. I've been sort of procrastinating this morning because I knew that one of these days that I have off, I really wanted to leave the house because I never really do that, especially since my days off, I'm usually alone. And I don't really like going out by myself. It's not fun. And I haven't really been accomplishing as much as I would have liked. You know, like this took a long time just signing and labeling the back of these because I don't have sticky labels to print on. And I can't drive anywhere to get more, so whatever. These look great. I'm happy with these. I signed those too. I numbered them because I decided that I'm probably not going to print any more copies. This is probably going to be it. I think 26 is enough. You know? I think it's enough. And after this show is done, I'm going to keep moving. I'm going to do something else. So I don't want to have to backstock on stuff like this. I have this old camera I bought forever ago. They're expensive now because they don't make them anymore. But I've got... It looks like... Oh my gosh, I can't even see it. It looks like there might be one or two photos left on this. Is that a 9? That's a 3. Or 6 or something. There might be like 4 photos left on this thing. And I kind of want to just use it up because... I can't even remember when I put the film in here. So I couldn't even tell you what's on this film roll. Which is why I really like film cameras sometimes. Because I like the surprise element of it. The lens on it is really unique. And it makes these interesting pictures with color and things. It's an outdoor only camera. So I don't use it that frequently. Because I don't go outdoors though. But it's autumn. And there's some excellent colors out there. So I should take this with me, just in case. And I already wound it by accident, so I gotta use it. Or else I'm gonna accidentally take a picture of my floor or something. Oh boy.